Hi, everybody. I've got another journal for you today, and it is a fabric journal. Let's measure this puppy. I brought a ruler with me today. It is 5 1/4 by 8, so it's a nice size. On the front, we have some coffee-dyed fabric that's been sewn, and I made a little flower out of it with a button center. It's got coffee dyed and the natural white fabrics on it. And there's the spine. And there's the back. Again, a nice little eyelet coffee dyed. I just think the coffee dyed with the white is so pretty together. Little tip of a flower here, rosette flower. Just kind of peeking out from behind. Let's go inside, see what we got. We have got a thread. That's what we've got. We have got here a pocket that matches the outside cover. And it's been sewn on. And it's got some sari ribbon and some lace and a little bow. On the inside, with yarn, attached together with yarn, we have a tag. Coffee dye tag, some envelopes. You know, I like to do my envelopes and show those. Nice little piece of coffee dyed paper to write on. But goes right back in this. You have two of those, and you've got a photo mat. You could put a picture here, and you can journal on the back. On this side, we have a real pretty music scrapbook paper here, a digital image. Real nice floral background. And again, some coffee dyed papers. Get them back in there, one by one. That's a piece of sari silk that's been sewn on. Little tulle bow. And a big sheet of lace here, coffee dyed paper with lace on it. And it all fits all in there. And here's some lace underneath the pocket and some thready yarn. On this side, I leave my threads. If they bother you, just cut them off. But I don't know. I think it just adds a little something. Here, we have a glassine bag. Behind it, got a really pretty pearl topper on that one, and just some fabric here, and it goes right behind the bag with a piece of ephemera, coffee dyed ephemera. And inside the bag, a little flower with some sheer fabric gold thread sewn on it. See, I just let my sewing go. I don't I'm not trying to be perfect. I like the irregularity. I just think it gives it a lot of character. And here we've got a little card and a little flower here that's been sewn. But see, I can sew straight if I wanted to, but I just think it's just a lot nicer when it's a little irregular. Just adds a little something. Over here, we have a really pretty background to this paper with a butterfly and a, what do you call that? A applique, but it's like a part of one. And then a pearl. A nice place to journal here with two cards. So it serves a dual purpose. It holds tags and it's a place to journal. Big page for journaling here. And a glassine bag with goodies. And it's got some pieces of paper in it. And you know, my signature snippets of paper that I always add. And we'll just tuck those back in. But you know, you could take one of these if you wanted to write something on it and say you put a picture somewhere. Like say you put a picture here. And you could put your picture on top of that, put it over an existing page, and write down here. Or you could write on the back of it if you wish. Over here, we have a really pretty booklet. And the string's not gonna fall off. It's on there. It's got a little tiny pocket with the pink to match and coffee dyed papers and some ephemera and just neat pages. I'll set that over there and come back to it. And in the front of this, because this is a pocket here, that's where I got it from with the lace top. In the front of this, we have a little mini booklet. How cute is this? Look at that. It's so cute. And an envelope. And it's got a little mini piece of paper in it. And a Rolodex card. And this has got a little tab up at the front with a little piece of bling. So several things to journal on there. I'll put the booklet back later. Over here, a really pretty ruffle fabric. And this is a pocket here. This came from a book of poems. Really nice poems. And it's got several pieces. A piece of ephemera. Coffee dyed paper. And a nice little tag with a sorry ribbon. Another big page to journal on here. Over here, we have layers of fabric on a pocket that's got that thready stuff, yarn. And then here, we have, this is a little holder with two tags in it. And some sewn paper. I love sewing just on the edge of paper. I think it's pretty. And we'll stick him back there. Several things in here. And of course, they're blank on the back, unless the sewing went through. So lots of things to journal on there. And over here, we have got a rosette with some little pretty paper fabric here. A little piece of metal with the pearl. Another big page to journal on. Over here's a little tuck spot with a rose and then some birdies. It's a little booklet. Piece of ephemera in the background. And over here we've got some places to journal. Isn't that just cool? I love it. I love the gold thread. It's just so pretty. And I try to fiddle around with some of the different stitches and see what they'll do and, you know, find my favorites. Here's a piece of coffee dyed paper on top of the white with a place to journal. And here's the other side of that glassine bag with more goodies. I just love that. And here is a card to journal on. Ruffle. Some just pretty fabrics. Never throw your scraps out. You can always find some kind of use for them. You know, or they're really not scraps. They're just more fabric. Here we're probably background with a nice place to journal again. And over here we have a little tuck spot. And it's got some little pieces that you can add stuff to. Or you can tuck more behind all my tuck spots. A pretty card. And this is that English to French dictionary that I got at an estate sale. A flower with some lace. There's a little envelope that I didn't put anything in. You can add whatever you want in it. And a big tag to journal on. A pretty background of roses. Who doesn't like roses? Okay. Having issues? There we go. And we'll put you in the back and you in the front. And I like to, you know, have one raise up and so you can see all the pretties in there. piece of fabric here, ruffled. Another place to journal, and then the back. It's not been coffee stained or anything. It's just the plain white fabric. And then that's the back again. All the little coffee stains and imperfections are done on purpose. And this is it for this journal. I'm glad you were here with me today. And I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye.